I really like planar shavings. So fluffy. Welcome, welcome, welcome to the final part from the series How I Tune or Pimp My Planar. So in the last parts, I see on the comments some questions. But before we start on the last part, I will tell you why I do what I do. Let's start with the fans. So why I don't do this fence movable? So that's easy. I don't need this. It's very simple. I don't need to move the fence. And I tell you why. When I plane on this side, when I plane on this side, what I do when I plane the other side down, I plane this here. So that's why I don't need to move the fence. But if you have maybe a similar planar and you want to move the fence, it's simple to do. You make this mounting part a little bit longer, like so, and you make the fence on this part also a little bit longer, so, and you make some stops left and right, and you make a hole in the slot, and you can use this as a movable fence. It's easy to make, you see. So let's go to the next. The next thing is about this block for the blade guard. The blade is for planing 10 inch, not more. And the distance between here, it's a little bit more as 10 inch. So when I plane a board, this is not in the way because the planer, you see, here's a gap between. I cannot plane more as 10 inch. It's not possible. So this is for me not in the way. And one more question. You are happy with this planer? And yes, I'm happy with this planer. The motor have 1.5 horsepower, and that is really enough. I don't use this planer every day for 1,000 feet of wood. For a normal workshop, this is really enough. You don't have to buy a very expensive planer. So I'm happy with this. The planer do what the planer do, and the power is enough. And with the little improvements I make, it's a perfect machine for a little shop. And the last improvement what I want to make is this under table. I call this under table. On the outfeed side, there's some iron, but this is not really what I want. So I wanna make a plate, piece of wood, plywood, to go in like so, but not too much, because when I plane small boards like this, and this is up, I have to push it in and I need some place, so I have to find a good measurement for the infeed and for the outfeed, because I want to put out the wood. So the first what I need is a measurement for how long I want to make this board. So the smallest pieces what I plane, I think it's 40 centimeter. This comes out, the last hole is here, so I think, yes, from the middle of the planer head, 35 in this direction and 35 in this direction, 70 is good. So 70, 45 in the middle, the board come in, pass the planer, oops, and the last roll, 70 is here, and I can grab the board. Yes, it's perfect, 70 is perfect, so cut the board. So here's my board cut in length. I do the start and the end with a 45 degree cut, and I'm not really sure with the top for the wood. I think beeswax will do the job, but I will glue the melamine on top. I know it's not big enough, it's a rest piece. I don't have this here for the moment, I have to buy. with the melamine and the beeswax, I think the wood don't stuck. Don't stuck in the planer. So I hope so, I'll try this out. So next what I have to do is to fix this under here, and I want one or two screws so I easily can remove this if I need it. So I don't know, I remove this or I use this for fix the board. No, I think I don't remove this, I use this for fixing, maybe. No, I don't remove this. No. Okay, next step. I think I remove it. Here you can see it's not, this is not straight. And nothing, I don't want to use this for fix this board. So I put this off. So what I do is I mark the center, the planer head and the outside from the housing, so I can make this board exactly center. And for this end I make a little stop block and I glue this on here so I can push the board in and have a stop point for the, and I can screw the plywood on this table from underneath with 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 screws if I want. So let me glue this in, and with the stop block in place I can paint the underside and the sides, and after I glue the melamine on the top and I let this dry a couple hours. Whoops, and back from the home center. So I can glue the melamine on the top, and with a coat of beeswax. I think the wood lips properly the planer. So glue this up. So this goes in here and the stop block against the standard table, and I fix this with a couple screws from underneath. So now the tuning parts are finished. I add a bigger spring for the fence. So much more power. One last thing, some idea in the comments I see, it's to put the spring on the inside, but this is not possible because, let me show this, when I plane on the underside the wood comes out here, so here is no place for the spring on the inside. So I give a complete turn. New guard, new fence, new cable. So what I need again, it's some better push sticks, but this I make in another video. So let me know in the comments what do you think. Thanks for watching.